Scientists recently solved the biggest mystery in animal reproduction, eel sex. Or at least that's what all the mainstream media and science reporting and press releases would have you believe. According to them, in 2022, science finally figured out where eels make babies. But this discovery was not actually a discovery at all, because more than a century ago, a decidedly low-tech but ingenious study had already given us the answer. Hi, I'm David, and this is Minute Earth. Freshwater eels were once so plentiful in European rivers that people pulled them up by the bushel, baked them into pies and jellies, and ate them nearly every single day because they were so much cheaper than other meat or fish. But no one could figure out where all these eels originated from. No one ever saw eel sex, or eel eggs, or eel babies. No one could even find eels' reproductive organs. Aristotle hypothesized that eels were spontaneously generating in puddles. Sigmund Freud got obsessed with eel genitalia and dissected hundreds of specimens before finally finding one that had actual gonads. But no one was able to make real headway on the so-called eel question until the early 1900s. A Danish scientist named Johannes Schmidt happened to be aboard a marine research vessel off the Faroe Islands when the nets pulled up one of those freshwater eels, one of the smallest ever documented. Considering how young the eel was, and the weird fact that it was in salt water, Schmidt hypothesized that it must be on its way to its adult habitat, the rivers of Europe, from somewhere in the Atlantic, where it had presumably been hatched. But to figure out where exactly, Schmidt needed a lot more data, so he asked the captains of Danish trading ships headed for America for a favor. Every few days, they'd trail a net for 30 minutes and send him whatever they pulled up, along with the date and the location. This went on for 15 years, during which time Schmidt also made several of his own sampling journeys. When he finally plotted the data from this mountain of samples, Schmidt found that as ships moved west from Europe across the Atlantic, the eels first got smaller and smaller, and then, as they got closer to America, they got bigger and bigger. Ships that took a more southern route tended to find even smaller eels throughout their journey. The very smallest eels were found in spring and summer in an area about 1,000 miles off the coast of Bermuda, known as the Sargasso Sea. With this data, Schmidt was able to put together pretty much everything we know, even today, about the wildly elaborate reproductive cycle of the European eel. The adults make a year-long, multi-thousand-mile journey from the freshwaters of Europe to the Sargasso Sea, developing their reproductive organs along the way. The lone eel with gonads that Freud found must have gotten started a little early. Once they get to the Sargasso Sea, the eels mate, probably in buried deep water, then presumably die and sink to the bottom. Once the eggs hatch, the babies rise to the surface. The baby eels then spend 3 years riding the currents back to Europe, arriving as mostly mature adults. So what had seemed like spontaneous eel generation was actually the result of one of the longest animal migrations in the world. Since Schmidt's breakthrough, scientists have kept trying to learn more via hundreds of research trips to the Sargasso and lots of fancy new equipment. All the evidence they've gathered along the way has essentially supported Schmidt's theory. The most recent evidence is the first ever direct tracking of a single adult eel's entire journey from Europe to the Sargasso Sea. But they turned up almost nothing new. We've still yet to find a single wild eel egg. When it comes to some mysteries, at least, you don't need direct evidence or high-tech gadgets. With some ingenuity and a boatload of perseverance, sometimes the truth can be revealed.